didn't let Mom get a drink or put her earrings back in. But
well, because it's late and we're kind of winding down. And
yeah.
Okay, so.
Welcome to the Straw Family Farm.
I'm Christy.
I'm mean. I'm mean.
He's mean, mean. Okay, let's start in the chapel.
Seek first the kingdom of God, and all these things will be added to you. Matthew 3:6-6. Oh, 6:33. Sorry, not 6:33. Just yep. Edit.
Chapter 6, verse 33.
Yep.
Okay.
First seek the kingdom of God, and all these things will be added to you.
Okay, so we've been seeking, correct, in our daily lives. Trying to do the right thing, trying to do the good thing. Yay! Okay, so moving on. He's eating popsicles. Get rid of the rattly. Okay, so in the barn stalls. Quit jiggling the camera. In the barn stalls.
We had a new baby day.
Yep. And what's the problem with the new baby?
It has to be named a gemstone name. It should be named a movie character.
Rose Quartz is her name, but who's her mom?
Snow. She wasn't supposed to be bred.
So,
hey, it's a bonus. We'll take bonuses.
We held out two. We didn't want to breed this year, and both got bred. So, either somebody's a master of getting them through the fence, or something. We don't know how that happened. So, Snow had a little baby girl today, right? And she, it's on silent, sorry. She's doing really good with it. We have it in the barn. Now, we also have biscottis in the barn. What's wrong there?
You got a limp.
A big limp, doesn't she? Mm-hmm. They did okay, and we let them out, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then, what, two days later?
Yeah.
What? Found her. She's a twin, so we don't know if Mama's stepping on her or twin is stepping on her or what, correct?
We're not sure.
Don't know. So, yeah. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Anything else in the barn stalls? Yep. Come on. You're in the barn stalls. The horses.
Oh, we have two.
Man and Fred.
Yep. We have two new outside horses.
Okay. And they're from Southern Oklahoma.
Uh-huh.
Guys are trying them. Trying RJ. They had not heard of him and don't know who he is. And so they're going to give him a shot. And if he does a good job, could turn into a regular job for them. Mm-hmm. Right?
Yep.
Okay. Anything else? In the barn stuff. You're riding Star, Durf. The only one who hasn't been ridden out here on the farm is Cavayu. Right?
Yep.
You're too into that. You're not talking at all. It's melting.
And it's 80 degrees in here, so yes, it's melting.
Yeah, Dad's been doing the fire, so. Okay, so what else? Anything else in the barn stalls? Mm-hmm. One more thing. The calf. Pink cast.
Oh, yeah. The accident.
The accident.
So we had a mishap here. I had a mishap here.
You had a mishap. Now, let me explain something. And all the time that RJ's been roping, he has never had this happen before. This is not something that's common occurrence, but it happened. He's not sure how it happened, but it happened. So, what happened?
Keith broke its leg while I was roping it.
It stepped off in a hole or twisted it funny or something, and it broke its leg. It wasn't anything RJ did. It wasn't anything he didn't do. There is no fault to be had. It just happened.
Yep.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So, and it is not commonplace. So let's hear how it was handled. You called around, got some help, right?
Yep.
And
we made her cast.
She is now cast from just below her hip all the way down. Just because the knee is it's not broke at the knee. It's broke up here, but we want to keep it totally straight. and we cast it that day.
Yep.
And we'll cut it off in about 3 or 4 days when swelling goes down, because it'll get loose and then it'll rub. So we'll be checking it here in a few days and then recast it for a permanent cast for 6 weeks. 6 to 8 weeks, just depending on how it does. She's doing really good getting around on it and stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
She won't be roped anymore. It's just the way it is. So, it happened, and there's no reason for it to happen. It's not something that's common occurrence, and we really don't know how it happened. So, the only thing RJ can say is that she stepped funny. And so that could be a hole, that could be a twist. That was his, he did not have the cam on when he was doing it. So we really don't know. He just said she stepped funny. It wasn't that the horse did anything different. It wasn't a horse fault. It wasn't a cow fault. It wasn't an RJ fault. It just happened. And sometimes there is no answer other than it just happened. So it just happened. We feel bad. We don't like that it happened. But it happened and we dealt with it. So, there it is. All right. Mending fences. Anything that you had to fix on our place?
Nope.
Nope. Been fixing for other people, but nothing here, really, have we? Okay. Yarn farm. I guess I'd be on the porch. We've got our fiber stuff coming up, our fiber camp, and some activities. We've got a day scheduled for adults, an adult night. I don't have my book right in front of me. It's late. We've already eaten and we're getting ready to do chores and go to bed. Because RJ has a lot to tell you about how his days have gone.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't want to do it again by myself because apparently I'm boring. They miss, a lot of comments were, we miss RJ's antics. And today he's not doing anything but eating a popsicle. So, okay, mending fences, yarn farm. It's been raining here, and this is part of the problem, correct? You did get Star. We got video of Star, and that will be posting on YouTube. And you got some of Durf, right? What are you doing?
It's about to break. I don't want it to fall.
Don't put it over my table. Put it over your hand. Put your hand over there to catch it. There you go. You knew that was coming, huh? Okay. I try to be funny. I try to be funny. Okay, what's up next? In the garden, it's still raining. Now, we do have a project in the works for the garden, correct?
I guess.
Well, what's that mean?
I guess.
Yes,
I guess you could call it a project. I would not call it a project.
Then what would you call it?
A pipe dream come true.
A pipe dream come true. So, as most of you know, I got a little job. And
coming true, that's it.
Yes. And this weekend, I was actually supposed to break ground for my garden house. And for those of you that can visualize, it's going to be a 20 by 20. And I actually have a little sketch here. My daughter and I were going over it. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Okay, so I've got phone numbers from the, I wrote the Lawnmower Man's phone numbers on there, so I'm going to kind of take it down a notch here. I don't want you to see, strange people calling my Lawnmower Man going, oh, you're going to fix the lawnmower. Okay, so it's a 20 by 20 tiny house. It is going to be garden-based. It's going to be light, airy. It's going to have French doors that open up out into a, it's going to eventually have an outdoor kitchen, just a small one. But the outdoor kitchen and the greenhouse are going to wait. Right now I've got the 20 by 20, that I'm going to start working on. And this is the plan. You'll walk into, oops, I've got to do it backwards here. You'll walk into the, French doors here. This just says grill. I've got it mapped out with my loom and where my wheels are going to be. This is a dining room table. The kitchen and the shower and the composting toilet will be right here. My shower, I found the tile. I'm gonna get the tile before I actually get the walls up because what happened? What happened?
She found it on sale.
47 cents for a 12 by 12 bathroom tile. So 47 cents a piece, that's $47 to do the three walls that I need to do for my rainfall shower. So, and I don't know if I want to plumb in water. We have water out there that I could plumb in, but I think I want to do gravity fed and I want heat on demand or whatever, hot water on demand.
I think your water pressure's not going to be very high.
It doesn't have to be. It's me for one shower. That's fine. So anyway, the other thing that I'm going to do is over here is going to be a platform bed with a small closet. And above the bed will be shelves for storage. And then right here, I'm going to do a corner for wood-burning stove and table, and a small end table and two chairs right there. And then my wheels will sit around there. For above this table right here, I'm going to have lanterns. I think I'm going to build it myself. I don't want to do a round, what do you call it? Wagon wheel type. I want it to be garden, not western. So I'm going to probably build a frame and put three or four. Ow. Quit. He's popping me with my own little hair thing. But I'm going to do the lanterns there. Now, the reason that I'm doing it that way, because I have seen many, many tiny house or tiny garden homes with the lanterns done on those little, they're like an L shelf and the lantern sits on top of it. Do not hit that camera with that. I will beat you. I mean it.
That's gonna shoot it right off there.
No, do not. Anyway, so I've seen them done that way. The problem is that they light up more, they illuminate more of the wall.
We should turn the attention. Mom, you hold the camera right here. Look at the sleeping cat. Hold the camera, and I'll shoot the rubber band.
No, don't you dare. Randy James, stop it right now. Not even. Not even.
He's asleep. You know how he's going to jump?
Not even funny. Okay.
It's hilarious. You know how he's going to jump? Hey, you got scared. You scare me all the time. So at least
okay,
I
he's an innocent cat. Anyway.
He terrorizes the house at 2 o'clock in the morning. He's not innocent.
He's not. Anyway, so I don't know. I'm going to make a way to have them hang down. Now, I have had two thoughts on this, and my daughter said one tonight. She says, Mom, if you hang it from the rafters, because I'm going to have trusses made to go over them, and they're going to be exposed trusses. It's going to have two skylights. I want to look at the stars at night in there if I sleep in there. And I want it to be my way, if that makes sense. So she says, Mom, if you make some kind of hanging thing and then hang your lanterns from it, she said, anybody who's any taller than you is gonna have a problem. I don't care. It's my residence, correct? My house, my thing. This is going to be my space. So as long as it's my space, you tall people, I don't wanna hear it, okay? Walk around. And it's going to be over the kitchen, the table too. So it's not like you're going to be walking under it. Or at least I hope not. Right? So, you're not very tall either, so you ain't got to worry about it.
I can't blow a dang bubble.
Anyway, so we were supposed to get in the 5x5s. We're doing it, not going in debt. We're going to do it a little out of my little extra paycheck. We were supposed to get the 5x5s. I had them online in my shopping cart, and then Lowe's switched their thing again and only wanted it truck delivery. And they wanted to charge me $80 on top of mileage to get them here. I wanted to take my own truck and trailer and go get them. They're just 10-foot 5x5s. So
I called another lumber yard, and my daughter told me I need to try another one. She said that the one here in South Cockville is a little bit more expensive than the one in Independence. So tomorrow I'm gonna have RJ call and check Woods and Independence and see if it's any cheaper, because the 5x5s are actually the most expensive thing that I'm looking at. There's about $300 in 5x5s. And then the headers are only like $135, and that's inside and out.
Well, I'm going to buy a new head for $135.
No, headers, fix, header boards.
You can fix two the by problem sixes. You're always having of hearing your voices.
I like my voices. They talk to me. I'm never alone.
We can fix that problem, though.
And then I've got a...
That's cheap. You can get a new head for that. And then, you can come with a full color head of hair. Do it all that gray streaks, you know?
Yes, all that gray is RJ's doing.
No, that's all sister. I haven't given you very many of those.
Really? Anyway, so...
just at least two dozen.
I'm going to do a rainfall shower with tile. I'm going to do a composting stool, which is just going to be a bucket system, but I'm going to build it in so that it looks really nice. And then I'm just going to have a kitchen sink in there. And anything that I do this summer's, now I have decided I'm gonna put some solar out there because
it's gonna be cold.
Well, no, the solar power isn't for the cold, is it? What's it for?
I don't know, you tell me.
My little fridge. I've decided I can't give up my goat's milk. So I have to have goat's milk cheese, that kind of stuff. And if I'm gonna make that, I need a place to keep it because I don't eat it all at once. So, I'm going to have a little fridge. And it's just going to be one of the small college, I don't know, 4.7 cubic. They're like $60 here, $68, $69. Like, yeah, just little bitty. And then I'll be able to charge my phone and do the laptop. So, that is it. I still will be able to edit videos and that. So, and I'm good with that. But that's the only electric that's going to be down there. And then... my on-demand water, right?
You're shaking the camera.
On-demand is going to be, if I decide to do it, it runs a little bit on electric too. But I want to see if I can get it done with a propane tank. So, why are you going to sleep? Come on. It's only like 7:30, guys. Come on, son. Let's finish. Okay, so that's in the garden. All right,
bye, folks.
Oh my god. This is why we don't podcast late. Okay, so, there's Moose. He's got lasagna breath, too. I don't want him in my face. Okay, so that's in the garden, and that's our big addition for the garden. That's the one thing that we're going to be working on. So who's building this thing, son? That was my next question.
The bat dog.
Quit. Yes, him's bat dog. Quit. Put him down. Who is building it?
He's bumping my feet with his tail.
Who is building it?
You.
Yep. RJ's going to help me with the trusses because I don't know that I can get those up. And he might have to help me with the headers. But other than that.
I am. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay.
And then it's going to have exposed 5x5s. I'm going to sand them down, seal them. And...
Oh, that poor cat.
I know, I almost missed. Oh my god.
I already like let go of it and it was going.
But it's gonna have white walls with exposed 5x5s and pretty much it's a popsicle stick. It's not like you can stick it in him.
Want a bat?
Quit. Poor cat.
That's gonna right, come so, eat this.
So that was in the garden, right? Or in the field. What else we got going on? In the farmhouse. Tell them about your days. Come on.
Let's see here. I have a funny bone. It's not funny.
Yes, it is. No, okay, so come on. In the farmhouse, what have you been doing?
Right now, I'm dying. My arms are dying.
Okay, come on, so we can get done. Come on,
what did I do?
Roping. Monday,
I roped. I got two outside horses in.
That wasn't Monday, that was Wednesday.
Well, Monday I wrote. I knew that. And Tuesday, I don't remember what I did, so I just skipped it. Wednesday, I got my two outside horses in.
Thursday is when the calf broke its leg.
Yeah.
Right?
No.
And then.
Yeah, that was Thursday, but yeah, it was Thursday.
It was Thursday. And then Friday, you went to a rodeo, right?
Yep.
Tell you a story about your rodeo and how much money you won.
I won $180.
How much did you have in it in entry fees, son?
I had $170. All right. I was kind of disappointed. Only made $10 and I won two checks. But sure beats a slap on the back and a poke in the eye. So I was okay with that.
Okay. How much gas money did you have in it, though?
I probably had more than gas in it. But it sure bet not beat nothing.
There you go.
I mean, so, it's been a slap on the back and a poke in the eye.
Yep. Okay, and then...
Whoa, I can stick this
to... Yeah, yeah, no, I don't want it stuck to anything.
I can stick to my head.
Okay, but you can't put that sticky thing back on there.
A bit.
Now you've exposed it.
Look at this. Just look at this. Would you look at this?
Uh-huh. Okay, so Saturday, what did you do?
We watched it rain. Two outside horses.
I was supposed to be setting those posts on Saturday.
Yeah, it rained. I was soaked.
And it rained, and you ended up going up to your uncle's and working and being soaked totally through. Oh, we went to a birthday party.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Very different birthday party.
I have a girlfriend from Pennsylvania, and she lives down here. And the north is a little bit different than the south, and city is a little bit different than country, and so... we went to her 50th birthday party, and they had smoked bologna.
Yeah,
RJ's just like slice it up, put on some bread. No, they had a big thing, chunked it.
Like Freddie does it, but they don't do it. They do it like Freddie and them, when they make it, they put it on a smoker, stick it outside, and like you're eating it off the smoker. They had it in a crock pot. You don't smoke bologna in a crock pot. There's no smoke, folks. I mean,
then,
I've never met a crock pot that smokes.
And then, what about the pulled pork?
Yeah, I just kind of looked at it.
Had chicken.
And the pork chicken, thank you all did.
Okay, their jello is like mango jello with peaches in it.
Yeah.
And RJ's like, no. Oh.
At first I thought they were jello shots, like alcoholic. And
well,
because
we didn't have wine, and I said, no, they're not. They're just regular jello.
I thought it was alcoholic. And Mom, she's like, no, this is not alcoholic. I was like...
No, it's just mango jello with peach.
Right? So, it took me a little bit. I mean, it's a little different.
And then he met... Beth has two daughters that are like 2 years younger than RJ. And, well, 2 and 3 years
younger. One's a year older, one's a year younger.
No, she's not a year older. Yeah, Alexis is, because she's fixing to turn 21. Okay, so she's like 6 months older than you. And then one is just younger than you.
Yeah, there.
So anyway, they had brought their friends home for Mom's birthday, the boyfriends and a roommate.
A best friend.
Yeah,
or
best.
Or what?
No. Okay.
Friend.
And Gabby goes in and wants to introduce RJ to all of her friends.
So
right?
I was standing around like a sore thumb. I mean, you could just pick me out of there at any point.
Yeah.
Any day. I could have gladly left and nobody would have noticed.
We would have noticed. Beth would have noticed.
Well, yes. The lady that the party was for, she would have noticed. Anybody else would not have noticed.
Would not have noticed. So Gabby grabs him, and she always has her and Alexis always have big hugs for RJ. You know, just as friends, not anything. He takes good care of their dogs when they're gone, huh? And so they grabbed his neck and, oh, come over here. And they were introducing him. And what did you find out about your handshake, son?
I have a firm handshake.
Oh, we didn't know there was any other kind, did we?
No, I did not.
RJ, when he left, his mom was like shaking two girls' hands.
Yeah, I mean, they're like really soft and like really like.
Yeah. And then he said he felt old. And the kids were like, oh, I don't hurt when I get up. And I looked at him and said, son, they don't work as hard as you do during the day.
I said, I feel old. Well, dang, I said, I feel old. And the other guy just kind of looked at me and I said, and I popped off being sarcastic, meaning about the old school handshake. But I decided I'll just take another approach to this, see if we have something in common. And I went, oh, I mainly feel it in the morning when I get out of bed. And he goes, I said, when everything goes to popping and crackling. And he goes, that doesn't happen to me. I said, you don't wake up sore. And I thought, wow. He goes, no.
Nope, because they don't do anything but go to school, study, you know, get up the next morning and go. So RJ's figuring out that his job is kind of hard on the body.
Did not realize it was. I mean, I could have lived my whole life and nobody would have told me, and I just would have thought that was normal.
That was normal.
Did not realize.
So that. You're normal, and no, he's weird, not normal, right?
Yeah, I never would have. I just would have thought everybody felt that way when they got out of bed.
But it's
they had to make that they're like, oh, I don't want to do this. We'll just be happy
today. Yeah. So, but it was kind of funny because RJ is, and he understands now why I call him an old soul in a young kid's body, because he just, you really didn't have anything in common with them, did you?
I was smarter than them, I can tell you that.
Yeah.
I figured out. Just
okay,
from,
so
just
they had about, another discussion.
So they started having this discussion. I just kind of stood there and, and listened, all right? I wasn't really any help on this. And by the way, I don't drink, okay?
No.
Anybody knows, I don't like to taste alcohol. I just don't drink. So you guys are sitting there drinking wine, which I found that odd to begin with. I mean, just guys drinking wine. Just those sentences shouldn't go together, in my opinion.
All of his friends drink. If they drink, they're going to grab a beer.
Beer or whiskey or something. I mean, it just...
It's just not wine. Wine is a woman's thing to him.
Yes. I mean, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with it.
It's just not... His friends just don't do that.
Doesn't...
I'm the weird one because I've always got wine.
Yeah, Mom always drinks wine and nobody ever really... I mean...
And Beth always drinks wine.
Right. It must be a northern thing. I'm not sure. But they're talking about how they get drunk faster off of wine than beer. They're saying, yeah, I'll just be sitting, having a glass of wine, hanging out. I might have two, and then I'll be perfectly fine. Then all of a sudden, I am drunk. I mean, and I was like,
now comparing apples to apples.
He goes, I can drink beer and drink way more beers than I can wine, even though it has like the same alcohol content in it.
Yeah, they were talking apples to apples that the alcohol content was the same. When we cross the state line in Kansas, the alcohol content in beer is higher. So, and here in Oklahoma, it's a little bit lower. But they were saying if the alcohol content is the same, beer, they can have three or four, and it doesn't really even get them buzzed. But if they have just two glasses of wine,
they're drunk,
and they just don't understand it.
I told them, I said, if you want my two cents on this thing, I said, you might not. It's because you sit down, you drink the wine, and then when you stand up, it all hits you at once. I said, when you're drinking beer, you're up, you're moving around, you're having a beer. And you're moving around. It's not just sitting in your stomach. They went, And I don't even drink, and I know this stuff.
Yeah. So, it was just so funny because they sit and they don't... It's almost like... They live in their own little world, but the other hand, RJ lives in his own little world, and the two of them didn't go together this weekend, did they?
No. I mean, I could...
On the upside, I will say that I'm not, I don't fit in with Beth's other friends either, but it was Beth's birthday, and we're all friends, so we were there.
You fit in better than I did, I'll say that.
I do. A couple of the ladies there, I know them. They drink wine coolers. I drink wine. They don't like wine, and I don't really care for wine coolers, but unless it's Mike's frozen lemonade. But anyway, besides that. But Beth and I, and she had another friend down from Pennsylvania, which I fit in very well with. So I think that just us three from the north there were raised a little bit different than here. So, but we had fun, right? We did that. And you ended up leaving there and going and riding a horse again.
Uh-huh.
And...
I was glad to get out of there. Almost left early.
We love
almost
Beth.
Almost did.
We love Beth, but...
Great lady. And if it wasn't for her, I would have... I rode by that party on a horse about 15 minutes before I showed up. And I could have told you, by the kind of car sitting in the driveway,
RJ's the only one that drove up in a truck.
I was not going to enjoy it.
They all looked at him. He's got a food truck. Oh, we got to take that truck back too tonight, don't we?
What truck?
Eddie's.
It's already up.
Oh, okay. Anyway, sorry. But
yeah. I,
So, it was an interesting weekend. It was a fun weekend, right?
Yeah.
Just a little different. And I took Beth back. We have this ongoing joke. Okay, so Beth had this Calamity Jane wine. And her and I want to try it together. Like, she wanted me to try it with her. She says, I've got this bottle of wine. We're going to have to break it open sometime. And I said, okay. So, something happened where she felt like she needed to give me something. I don't remember what. Oh, the dog. We came up and had been chasing her dog several times. And she's like, here, take this wine. It'll make up for it. And I said, no, we're going to try that together. She says, okay, we'll try it at your house. She says, here, just make me feel better. So, I took the wine. Well, for her birthday, I put the wine in a fancy bottle bag and put a note on it and told her that the wine wasn't the gift, it was the memories and friendship that her and I were going to share when we got around to tasting it. And this bottle of wine has been passed back and forth now. How long have we been passing it back and forth? 3 months? 4 months?
Oh.
3 or 4 months. Well, since Christmas. Since right around Christmas time, so this is April.
At least 4 months. January, February, March, April. And at the end of April.
Yep. So, about 4 months, we're passing it back and forth. We are going to drink it. It's called Calamity Jane, and it's, I don't know, I don't think it's a white wine, but hey, we're going to try it. Anyway, I spun some yarn, right? I did 328 yards of a 2-ply black Welch. Fiber that was given to me by a friend, and I kind of enjoyed it, but they had left some guard hair in it. It was a black Welch top that I spun, but it had, somebody had left guard hairs in it. They hadn't cleaned it very good, so I just picked them out as I went. You could see them. They were all white, but I spun that up this weekend while you were rodeoing, right? And then other than that, I have been working on finding fixtures for this. I found my tile on sale, so I'll have the tile before I even get the 5x5s in the ground. It is going to be a garden shack, so I'm super excited about that because I'm going to stick to wood and light. What the heck are you doing? Quit. Are you bowing up to me? Anyway, so but I've been working on that. I haven't decided. Here's a question for you: double sink or single sink? If I do a single, I want it to be wide enough to put a little pan in, you know, to wash my vegetables and that in. But I'm not sure I want a double sink. I really don't. And I want it to be like white porcelain.
I'll make
the sink. Stainless steel. You'll make it.
Slam.
No.
That's awesome. You can't tell me that wouldn't be awesome.
No, it won't hold any water.
Right, that's the cool part.
Okay, that's great for washing your hands. He saw this amazing countertop that was at a slant, and the entire thing, the water just ran out onto it, and then it rolled back into a drain thing and down into the pipe to drain away. So there was actually no basin to it, which is great for washing your hands in the restroom. We all know that. Maybe even a little brushing your teeth. But it is not good for washing vegetables or food prep or dishes or
anything. Why not? Who needs that? Who needs it to hold water? It's awesome. It drains.
A kitchen sink needs to hold water.
Well, then I'll put it in your bathroom.
I'm not having a sink in my bathroom.
Oh, wait, you're not even having a whole bathroom.
No, I'm not having
you're
a
just
shower
having
stall
a bucket.
And a composting toilet. That's it. So... anyway, but I've been working on this. I found some amazing French doors that will pull in, and they've got the blinds in the center, so I won't have to dust as I get older, right? Mostly construction stuff, very little furniture, correct? So, I know. I can't
wait. You
gonna
take the cats with you?
No, I'm taking Moose with me. The cats are all yours. Moose will be residing down at the little house, away from people, and his kennel will be down there and everything.
Come here, you're moving
and,
out.
Yep. when I get the house built, it's not even built yet, but Moose will be going down there because well, folks, that way...
say goodbye to him. It's going to be his last appearance.
No.
Bye, bye, Moose.
I don't even have it built yet.
He's going to the China store.
You are not.
He's going to the Chinese food store.
He'll be the next hot dog.
If you order a hot dog, they'll have him on a shish kebab for you.
It's that way he does, because he likes to get upset and bite at people, and I don't want him biting anybody, so he'll have his own. I was going to make it today and make him an actual bed. He likes to go up and lay on Hanky's bed, and I was going to make him his own so that he's got his own bed and stuff, but that's kind of the cart before the horse thing. I don't have the building built yet, so... But he'll have his own bed and stuff down there, and it'll be a Moose house. So, and him and I will be hanging out in the garden shack. But I have decided I'm going to make it a little bit fancier just because that's what I want. And if this is the last big construction project that I do, I want to make it what I want. So, make myself happy. I will be a hippie, a long-haired, barefoot hippie down there with my dog.
Hanging out with the hippie and the cowboy.
Now there's your country tune.
Already made a song called that, Mom.
Who did?
I don't remember who made it, but it's called Hippies and Cowboys. There's a song about that.
Okay. We'll have to find that. So you guys Google Hippies and Cowboys song.
That's the song. It's called Cody somebody sings it.
Okay. Anyway, we're going to get off of here, and I will talk at y'all later. RJ, you done?
See y'all later, folks. And a good shake for the go.
Stop.
Okay, we'll stop.